Okay. Hello, everybody. Welcome to the lecture of the bioseparation. For this lecture, we will focus on the aqueous to phase extraction. Previously, we talked to you about the organic solvent, that's either solute or aqueous and organic surface. For this case, we call this aqueous to phase extraction. This means we have only two phases, right? Light phase and heavy phase. But for this case, both light phase and heavy phase includes water. We call it aqueous to phase. That's right. But we combine two water soluble polymer or a polymer and a salt in water for this case. Mostly we have two cases, right? Water and polymer, right? Or polymer and salt in water, right? Above the critical concentration. Right? And then we can separate the phase into immiscible liquid phase. One is the enlist in one polymer, and other enlist polymer or salt. The soluble or particulates separate add to the system, partition themselves between the two phase. Equate to phase extraction, or stand for ATPE, has become recognized as the technique that's non-denaturing or non-degrading technique, because it can separate the activity of protein, activity of enzyme, act of viral, something like this, because this is the non-denaturing or non-degrading technique or separate sensitive biomolecule like enzyme, protein, virus, cell, something like this. That's right. Each two-phase aqueous system can be characterized by the phase diagram as shown in this. In this case, we show right, the phase diagram for the aqueous two-phase extraction. Right. In the curve line is the equilibrium. That's right. Two-phase is in equilibrium. The lower zone, that's right, we eat one phase. That's right. The upper zone is shown in that two-phase. It's separate in the immiscible liquid phase and water phase, separate. For this case, and the timeline we come with the composition for each phase. This is, we can call it use the technique of invert level out. For example, we call this point is the top phase. This point is the bottom phase. And if we start at the end point, it's the mixture at the start. And then you can calculate the volume of the top phase, volume of the bottom phase by using the invert level out. Right. For example, if you would like to calculate the ratio of the volume of the top phase divided by the volume of the bottom phase, that's right. You can calculate by the length from MB, this is the invert arrow, divided by MA, the length from M to B, divided by the length from MA equal to V top divided by V bottom. That's right. This is the technique to calculate like, the volume on the top phase and bottom phase. Right. This table shows you the example of the aqueous two-phase system, right? The component one is maybe polyethylene glycol in water, and the component two would like dextrin in water, polyvinyl alcohol in water, something like this. Or another is polypropylene glycol in water, and another phase is polyvinyl alcohol. This example of the aqueous two-phase system that we use to separate like the sensitive biomolecule. The mostly the partition into two phase is containing 85 to 99% of water. That's right. When we add the mixture of biomolecule and cell fragment partition between the phase by use the appropriate condition, cell fragment can be confined to one phase at the protein of interest partition into the other phase. That's right, other phase. Okay. After we separate by aqueous two phase or by aqueous and organic phase. And then we have to separate the solute for the next step. It's maybe by the deterioration, by precipitation, or by ketonization. Okay. Mostly the ATPE we use to separate the phase only at the concentration in excess of a ceiling of critical concentration. That's like critical concentration. Top sort of phase is, and bottom is moon phase, and the top is the true phase. And the line connection between this point, as I showed you, like the timeline, is if we connect it to polyethylene, that's right, it is a big can, this phase, and Another percent is water. That's high. Another percent is water. Yeah, I talked to you already. ATPE is the two fat is depend on the biopolymer property, such as size of the biopolymer, charge on the biopolymer, the surface hydrophobicity. Hydrophobicity is not like water. Hydrophobicity is like water, and composition. Attach affinity ligand and property of the species, including size, type, concentration of the fat forming, something like that. Is it a parameter that affect, like the effect to the two fat partitioning or the fat separation? That's like if we lowering the average polyethylene glycol molecular weight or more, the molecular weight of the polymer, and increasing like the dextran molecular weight tend to increase K. K is partition coefficient that we can separate easier. Separate. Particularly for the higher molecular weight protein like catalase, compared with the cytochrome. That's right. For catalase, is the molecular weight with 250,000 Dalton, something like this, is a small molecule. Okay. The larger the difference between PEG concentration in the two fat, and also the more the partition coefficient derived from unity. If the partition coefficient derived from unity, that means it increase or decrease. It from one, that means we can separate by extraction easier. That's right. Okay. And the partial hydrolysis of dextran and PEG can increase KD, since the lower molecular polymer interact more strongly with protein. That's right. For example, the K value for fumarase is an enzyme increased by a factor of 6 when PEG 400 and PEG 4000 are mixed. That's right. For this case, we use two systems like PEG 400 and PEG 4000. But this fat mixed together in water. That's right. We got aqueous two fat polymer for this system. Okay. This is showing you like the effect of the molecular weight or the size of molecule that I talked to you in this slide. You can see that when the protein molecular weight increase, you can see that K value or the partition coefficient value is decreased. It's decreased. K value decreased is indicated by the low separation. That's like low separation efficiency. Something like this. Is it the kind of protein like insulin? That's like albumin. This is a small molecule of protein. This is a larger molecule of protein. Something like this. It is equalized. Is it, we can see that from the S increase in the molecular weight or the larger molecule of protein, the K value is decreased. That's indicated by the low efficiency for the separation by extraction. And also this shows the effect of pH on the K value. That's right. pH of the K value. That's right. This is the or the circle that's the open symbol, right? Like triangle, circle, and square. This is for the chloride salt. This is the effect of chloride salt. For the chloride salt, you can see that when pH increase, K value decrease. That's right. Decrease. That's it. That when the chloride salt pH increase, it will reduce the efficiency for separation. By for like the this is it, the close solid symbol is sulfate. That's right, sulfate. Square is potassium. Is potassium, sodium. That's right, and triangle is lithium. Okay, is it phosphate, sodium, lithium? For the phosphate, sodium, lithium, when the pH increase, mostly K value slightly increase. That means when K pH increase. For this salt system, the separation efficiency will increase. That's right. From this speaker. And another one, that's right, for the phase separation of low polymer concentration for low temperature in PEG dextran water system. By the opposite, that's right, it's true for PEG salt water system. Okay. That means PEG dextran water. The low temperature phase separation will occur at low polymer concentration for low temperature. Why phase separation occur at high polymer concentration at high temperature for this system? That's right. And lower temperature usually like partition coefficient, mostly like when temperature is low. That's right. Lower temperature. That's right. K increase mostly usually and increase separability or increase the efficiency for separation. That's right. Of high and low molecular weight for this case. Okay. Previously, we talked about the principle of the liquid two-phase attraction, and then we would like to calculate the desired equation if we consider the ideal state. That's right. From the first state, we make that's right, Li1, Ca1, Li2, Ca2, Li1, Ca1 is mean the phase 1 and phase 2. That's right. It's maybe only ethylene glycol in water, and solar is so used or molecule, and these are solution in water, and so you would mix together. That's right, mix together, and then after the setting, that's right. After setting, we get the separate upper phase and lower phase. Upper phase is LO1CaO1, LO2CaO2. That's right. For this phase, after the separate interphase, L is amount of folate of the upper phase. LO2 is the folate amount of the lower phase. That's right. CaO2 is the concentration of solute in lower phase. CaO1 is the concentration of solute in the upper phase. That's right. Okay. For this case, the partition coefficient can be calculated by the concentration of A of solute in the upper phase divided by concentration of solute in the lower phase. For this case, the CaU and CaL is in equilibrium. That's it. Concentration in the equilibrium. If K is greater than 1, what happens? If K is greater than 1, component A also used refer to the upper phase. That's right. That means CaU is greater than CaL. That's right. Most of the solute, most of the solute is in the upper phase. If K is less than 1, is less than 1. That means CaU is less than CaL. That means most of solute is in upper phase. That means solute prefer lower phase for that case. Okay. As I talked to you previously, right, the partition coefficient or the K value influence, that's right. It influenced by the size of molecule, of polymer, of cell, of protein, of solute. Agriculture, hydrophobicity, right? Like water or don't like water. That's right. So use molecule. That's right. They all specific affinity. For this, okay, for a single step attraction, only one step attraction of enzyme. Mostly K is greater than 3 are normally required. That's right. If you would like to separate enzyme with one step, K should be greater than or equal to 3. It's normal condition for the separation of enzyme. Okay, when K value is low, food product locally or yield can be achieved by using the volume of phase produced by the solute. Then, if K low, we have to need the volume of the phase. Okay, and then you can calculate the yield. That's right. Calculate the yield of A in the upper phase. Which U is the U of A of solute in the upper phase. You can calculate by U equal to VU CaU divided by VO CaO. V0 CaO. VU is the volume of upper phase. CaU is the concentration of solute in the upper phase after separation. VO V0 CaO is the initial volume and initial concentration of the solute. That's right. That means VUCA, VO, V0, CSO equal to VUCAU plus VLCAL. That's right. Here is the total amount of solute. That's right. Volume multiplied by C. C is mole or mass per volume. Volume divided by volume, you get mass of solute. That's right. Mass of solute. This is total in the feed. It's equal to volume, equal to amount at the upper phase plus amount in the lower phase. That's right. We want it to yield. That's right. Okay. For the yield in the lower phase, YL is defined as VLCL V0 CA0. It's the same. That's right. You can calculate this. And also, if we divide what numerator and denominator of equation 2 of this equation by CU, that's right, CAU, and recognize that the equilibrium CA and CU is K. And then you can express like YU in term of V and K only. That's right. This case in term of CAU, it's more complex, more variable. Okay. And we divide as upper and lower by CAU, that's right, and we express K as CAU divided by CA, and then you get like a simple equation like V, that's right. Y U is a function of V only, and K, that's a constant. V U divided by V U plus V L over K. And all the same, if we divide the equation 3 by CAL above, that's right, that's right, in numerator and denominator, you get the simple equation for Y, that's right, it is U of like this equation. Okay. And we can calculate like the purification factor, delta C. Delta C, if the partition code, if the delta C equal to CAL divided by CO, that means for this case, the product is equal to the lower profit. If C, delta C is defined as CAU divided by CA0, that means the product prefer to the upper phase. If delta C is higher, that means it's easy or separate. Efficiency is high. Okay. For this example, right, we use the equate to phase extraction to recover or to separate alpha amylase of enzyme from a solution. We use PEG, polyethylene glycol, and dextrane system. That's like PEG making water, dextrane making water, and is add to the solution to liquid alpha amylase. And then after setting, it's separate into phase. Okay, value is 4.2. It's the normal condition because we would like to separate enzyme. We need at least 3. Okay, at least 3. Okay, okay. For this case, calculate the maximum possible enzyme recovery. Okay, when the volume ratio of upper to lower, that's right, volume ratio V, U, per V, L equal to 5. And second one, V, U, per V, L equal to 0.5. What is the maximum concentration? That's right. The maximum possible enzyme recovery. Okay. For this case, the partition is greater than 1. For partition is greater than 1, what is meaning? The meaning is alpha amylase is preferred to the upper phase. That's right, upper phase. Okay, for this case, we can calculate like the yield of the upper phase. Right? We divide the numerator and the denominator by VL. Right? We divide the equation 4, right? We divide VU, VL, VU, VL, VL by VL. We get a new equation. The new equation like this. Okay. We get like YAU equal to VU over VL. VU over VL plus 1 over K. Because for the first one, you know, right, the ratio of VU over VL is 5. You substitute this to this and substitute K, you get U is 0.95. G, what does it mean? U is 0.95. What is the definition of G? This U, that's right. U is VU CAU divided by V0 CA0. VU is volume of the solution multiplied by the mass or mole of solution. So you divide this by volume of solution, you get it is the amount of solute in the upper phase. Divide this amount of solute in the initially, that's right, in the initially phase. Okay. If the amount of solute is close to 1, then that means amount of solute in the upper phase is go to the initial fit, that's right. If it reach 1 or close to 1, that means it's very, very high efficiency for separate. Right. For this case, if we utilize the ratio of VU divided by VL equal to 5. That's right. It's higher volume ratio with higher percent recovery. And also if we compare to 0.5 ratio, you get 0.68. And then we can say that if we increase the relative volume of extracting fluid, it will enhance the recovery or increase the recovery. In this case, we increase VU and VL ratio from 0.5 to 5. We increase from the percent recovery from 68 to 95%. That's it. Okay. For the next equipment or next extraction technique, the last one that I will talk to you is the supercritical fluid extraction. Before we talk about this technique, we would like to recall you about the thermodynamic of the supercritical fluid extraction. For this picture, I show you the diagram of the PET diagram of the system. If you study in thermodynamics, we have three phases, like solid, liquid, and gas phase. This is, we call this tipping point. At this point, at this pressure and this temperature, solid, liquid, gas are in the same, that's right. Yeah, in the same. These are mixed, that's right. Only one phase. If indeed condition is solid, this condition is liquid, and this condition is gas phase. If the temperature and pressure is critical pressure, it's critical temperature that is greater than this, we call this zone is supercritical. Right? This one is liquid, this one is gas, this one is solid. And this temperature and pressure, we call it a critical temperature. Critical pressure with the supercritical fluid from the phase diagram. That's right. Okay. The supercritical fluid, that's right, we combine the gas property that can be penetrate the substance easier when compared to the organic substance. That's right. If we use gas, that's right. The supercritical fluid is gas phase. It's easy to dissolve or it's easy to penetrate into the substance. Right. Than organic solvent. And also its density can be changed in a continuous manner by changing the pressure. The use of a supercritical reaction like carbon dioxide, it is the alternative, that's a technique to organic solvent. Because organic solvent is the environmental impact. If we utilize the supercritical fluid extraction or supercritical fluid, okay, this is the safe environment. That's right. And also for dissolving power of supercritical fluid, of a safe solvent for pharmaceutical food processing like this. That's right. But that's good for the food pharmaceutical, we need like supercritical fluid reaction is better because it's safe environment. That's right. It is also used for rapid removal of fouling components such as oil and grease from the water. Okay, some of the main application of supercritical fluid extraction, there are at least three. That's right. We use for separation and purification of essential oil and medical component. We use to remove the grease and other fouling material from the process equipment. And the last one, the food and beverage processing, like production of decaf of coffee. Decaf means decaffeine. That's right. It's very low caffeine content in the coffee. And alcohol-free beer. Alcohol-free beer means that no alcohol in the beer. Or smoothly, it's less than 0.05%. That's right. We use the supercritical fluid extraction to separate or to purification fermentation box, something like this. Or to separate oil. That's right. To remove the grease. That's right. From the fouling. Okay. And I talk to you because like the supercritical fluid, it can be easier to dissolve or it can be penetrated to the solute, to the solution, easier than the solvent. Like this show you, right, the solubility of the supercritical fluid extraction in solute. It can be increased with high pressure. Because the supercritical fluid is at high pressure, if you look at like the fluid diagram, the critical pressure and temperature is quite high. That means the supercritical fluid extraction. That means at high pressure, high solubility as high dissolved SOU. Okay. The supercritical fluid extraction can be used for both true form, like solid liquid extraction and liquid liquid extraction. Solid liquid extraction in the video, like the solid fluid extraction, sorry, solid fluid extraction and liquid fluid extraction. For this case, for solid, we use the SF or supercritical fluid to extract the solute in solid. For the liquid SF, that means we use like the SF to separate solute in the liquid phase. For this case, we can use for both. Okay. For the design of the SF, we need heat exchanger and compressor, because we need heat exchanger to condense some product and to compress the gas by compressor, right? And also we need to minimum mechanical contact arrangement, because this divided to high penetrability or high solubility or high penetrability of the SF, that's right, SF. Okay, for this solid SF tie extraction in the mass mode may be efficiently achieved using a packet bed extractor. A packet bed, that means we have a solid pack and then we flow like SF through the fluid pack. Its efficiency is higher for the bed system. And also it's the same organic solvent, because for this head fire example, like we have the ethanol phase water phase. Then we utilize the supercritical extraction for dissolved to extract the solute for that case. And this is the curve line, the equilibrium, three fluid in equilibrium. And this is the two phase zone. That's not in two phase zone. Okay. The next three, the last three slide, we talk about the configuration of the supercritical fluid extraction. The first one, like liquid solid, liquid SF extraction, that we use SF to extract solute from liquid. So for this case, the liquid is ethanol water mixture feed to the column. That's right, feed to the column and mix with the supercritical fluid or SF carbon dioxide. That's right, area carbon dioxide. After mixture between liquid and SF, the leffinate means the phase that includes like the solute or heavy phase, something like this. And extract phase. Extract phase includes the SF, which is the gas phase. And also we use like the reduction pressure or reduce the pressure to condense like the gas phase to the liquid phase. And then we get the liquid ethanol. And SF also regenerate or recycle to compress to the column. Okay. For this case, we have right liquid mixture. For this case, ethanol water mixture feed to contact with the SF, and then the leffinate feed or liquid feed. That's like the ethanol and water feed. That's right. To separate out by leffinate feed and the extract feed, as it includes SF and solute like ethanol. That's right. Sorry, this is the water feed. That's like some ethanol. This is the supercritical phase, that's right, and most of ethanol in the gas phase. And then we reduce the pressure to condense some ethanol. That's right, the ethanol we condense and separate out, and also we can recycle carbon dioxide again. That's right, this is the adiabatic compressor. There is no heat transfer between environmental and system. That's right. And mostly we can utilize the liquid and SF extraction for the best technique. For this case, we utilize the membrane at the product level, because the solution will penetrate through the membrane is easier. There are offer several advantages for the membrane. For example, like efficient segregation of the leffinate and extract, that means it's easy to separate between leffinate and extract. As shown in this picture, if we feed mixture, that's right, and we feed the SF also diffuse through the membrane and feed and SF contact the site contact, and also SF and Sujut will separate out at extract and feed with some of Sujut will refinate for out in this direction. For this case, it's easy to separate between refinate and extract, and also it's compact net product. It is a small equipment, it's low cost, and also large interfacial area, the area contact between SF and feed, things like this. And also constant interfacial area, which is independent of the fluid velocity. So this is the liquid. Yes. And the last one, we talk about the solid. As previous, we talk about liquid. Liquid in column and also liquid in membrane. And the last one is the solid SF extraction. Solid SF extraction, we would like to separate, right? So you would form solid by using like the supercritical fluid extraction. The solid particle need to provide, need to be by the SF. And then we feed caffeine bean into the column and then contact with the CO2, and then CO2 penetrate to the solid, right? And this lab the caffeine bean and coffee bean, and then we get the coffee. That's right. Some solid go out at the finite feed, and coffee, that's right, go out with the SF, that's right, we get coffee. That's right, need the solid feed, go out at the finite feed. Caffeine is separate out with SF, and then we reduce the pressure, caffeine will reduce in temperature, and then condense, we get caffeine and separate the recycled carbon dioxide to the process. This is the configuration of supercritical fluid extraction. Please note that the supercritical fluid extraction is preferred for now for the process because it is non-denaturing, that's right, non-degrading our product. If you use organic solvent like acetone, ethanol, it may be degraded by molecules, enzyme, protein, while something like this. But SF is safe for our product and also safe for the environment. Okay, I will stop like this lecture about extraction. In this, I talk to you about extraction in the liquid. So aqueous organic solvent, equate to fed separation by extraction, and the last one is supercritical fluid extraction. That's why the supercritical fluid extraction is the new technology and is more preferred for now, and it's easy. Easy, it can be used for now. That's why it's more common and more preferred for the by opposite, like up to now. That's right. Okay, see you for the next lecture.